Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we do computations with numbers in scientific notation using multiplication. The next video will have division, but these are the five problems we do on this video. You have to have a working knowledge of exponents, already know about scientific notation, positive and negative exponents, etc. We're going to use our calculators and the laws of exponents, which you see right here, and our knowledge of scientific notation to do some computations. So it's important to remember these laws of exponents. If you have the same base raised to an exponent, you write the base once and add the exponents. If you have the same base with different exponents and you're dividing, you subtract the exponents. All right, so here's the problem. Perform the computation and write the answer in scientific notation. I've got 2.3 times 10 to the 13th and 4.01 times 10 to the 5th. Now here's an example where it's convenient to have it in scientific notation. Otherwise, this would just be a really long number, this 2.3 times 10 to the 13th. The first thing we want to do is use our commutative property. This is all multiplied together, and I'm going to rewrite it in a different order. So we have the 2.3 times the 4.01 together, and I'm going to put the powers of 10 together, 10 to the 13th. I'm going to write it like this, times 10 to the fifth. Now, notice it's up to you whether you want to use this times sign that looks kind of like an X or the dot. The reason I'm using an X with decimals is so that you don't confuse that with the decimal points here. Now, let's go ahead and use our calculator to do 2.3 times 4.01, or you can get out a piece of paper and do that longhand. But in any case, you need to do 2.3 times 4.01. And that gives us 9.223. And I didn't write it here, but I could put a times symbol here, which might make it a little bit easier for this next step. What if I had, no, I'll just do it here. Times 10 to the, now, what would this be? 10 to the 13th times 10 to the 5th. You write the 10 down 1 and add the exponents. Now, the question is this in scientific notation? And it is, because I have a number between 1 and 10 times 10 to some power. So there we've done it. Now, if I wanted to write this out in decimal form or in this, like a standard number, it would just be a really long number, wouldn't it? You'd have to write it out. You'd have to move the decimal 18 places to the right. So that would be, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I think that does it. And that decimal point wouldn't be there, right? So I think that would be it, but you know what? I could have made a mistake. It's pretty tricky. You can see why scientific notation is the preferred form when you have a really large number. Imagine if that was 10 to the 180th power. I just couldn't get it on this page. All right, so our answer in scientific notation then, which was what was asked for, is right here. Let's do a problem similar to this where when I multiply the two numbers, I don't get it automatically in scientific notation. See how to do that kind of a problem. All right, here's our next problem. 8.34 times 10 to the 20th times 6.5 times 10 to the 30th. So again, I'm going to begin by putting the numbers together and multiplying them, 8.34 times 6.5 times, and I'm going to put, because this is all times, right? Even though I have a parentheses next to another parentheses, it just means times. And what do I have? 10 to the 20th times 10 to the 30th. And again, you could use a dot there to show multiplication. You could just put parentheses around both. That's up to you. So go ahead and use your calculator, or you can get out a piece of paper and do it the long way. 8.34 times 6.5 gives me 54.21 times, and then what does this become? 10 to the 20th times 10 to the 30th. I have the same base, so I write the base down and I add the exponents. 20 plus 30 is 50. Now, when you look at your answer here, is it in scientific notation? No, it's not, because of this number here. 54 is bigger than the number before the decimal point, right? It's not a single digit, for one thing. It has to be a number between 1 and 10. So now what I do is I rewrite 54.21 in scientific notation. All right, so we did that in a previous video. That's 5.421 times 10 to the first, correct? Right, because you'd have to multiply by 10 to get it back to this 54.21, times this other 10 to the 50th. So we've got 5.421 times, and now 10 to the first times 10 to the 50th is 10 to the 51st. So now I've written this in scientific notation. That would be really a pain if I had to move the decimal 51 places to the right, so you could see again why big numbers like this are much easier to write using scientific notation. All right, here's another problem. Perform the calculation and write the answer in scientific notation and also as a standard number, like a standard decimal number. All right, so see if you can do this on your own. There's three numbers to multiply out, and so feel free to get a calculator to help you with that. And put the video on pause and try it, and then come back and see how you do. All right, so the first thing we want to do is put the numbers together. 5.3, I'm going to write it just with parentheses, times the 6.1 and the 7.2. I could have written it all in one big parentheses with a time sign in between. Times, now, I've got 3 powers of 10. 10 to the negative 5. I'm going to put a parentheses around it, although it's unnecessary, because everything's multiplication. 10 to the negative 5, I'm sorry, that was 10 to the positive 5. 10 to the negative 6, and 10 cubed. So let's multiply these three numbers out together. I got out a calculator and I came up with 232.776 times, and then we need to add the exponents here. I'm going to go ahead and show the addition here. I'm adding 5 minus 6 plus 3. You could write that as plus a negative 6, of course. But we need to write this number here, this 232.776, in scientific notation. Well, what will that be? That will be 2.32776 times, all right, this is a bigger number, right? It's 232, it's not 2.32. So that's going to be times 10 squared. So that's this number here. Times, now what's this become over here? I've got 5 minus 6 plus 3, that's also 10 squared. Almost there. So I have 2.32776. And now my laws of exponents, 10 squared times another 10 squared is 10 to the fourth. So that's my answer in scientific notation. So that's the answer in scientific notation, right? How do we write our answer in standard form? I need to move my decimal 4 to the right, correct? 1, 2, 3, 4. It's going to be up to that second 7 over here. So that'll be 23277.6. That's the answer in standard form. So I've done that calculation. Depending on how you want to write your final answer, this one wasn't so bad to write in standard form. Again, if you want, you can put your comma here. But they both are, oops, I wanted to get rid of that little decimal point. They both are the answer to this, just written in two different ways. Okay, let's say we had this problem. This is 2 billion to the 6th power. Okay, you can't put that in your calculator because you try to raise it to the 6th power, it's got too many digits. But we can use scientific notation to sort of figure out what this would be. So one thing I could do is take the number in parentheses, this 2 billion, and write it in scientific notation. So that would be 2 times 10 to the 9th. Okay, and then that whole thing is to the 6th power. And now we could use our laws of exponents. When you have two things in the parentheses. Let me show you that law of exponents. So if you have AB to the nth power, you just raise each thing in there to the nth power. Okay, so we're going to use this. So that means I'll have a 2 to the 6th power times a 10 to the 9th to the 6th power. And you don't have to have this time sign showing between it either. I'm doing it because my final answer is going to be in scientific notation. 2 to the 6th. Right, do you know what that is? It's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. It's 64. And this will be 10 to the, what's our law of exponents here? Remember this law of exponent? You have b to the m raised to the n, you just multiply those exponents. So 9 times 6 is 54. Not quite in scientific notation yet, right? But I could write 64 as 6.4 times 10 to the first times that 10 to the 54th. And now I've got my whole answer in scientific notation. And that's the only reasonable way to write this number, right? Because we certainly aren't going to, have room to write it on a piece of paper. It'd have too many zeros. So 2 billion to the 6th power is actually 6.4 times 10 to the 55th. All right, here's another problem. The number is actually written in scientific notation as opposed to the previous problem, but it's raised to the 4th power. See if you could do this one on your own. Right, so what could we do first? We could raise the 3 to the 4th power, and then we raise the 10 to the negative 5 to the 4th power. So what's that give us? 3 to the 4th, 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is 81. And we're going to multiply these exponents, negative 20. But 81 is not scientific notation, so let's rewrite that as 8.1 times 10 to the first and the last thing to do is 10 to the first times 10 to the negative 20. Adding exponents gives us 10 to the negative 19. So this would be our answer to 3 times 10 to the negative 5 raised to the fourth power. Now, keep in mind, this original number may not have been written in scientific notation. It would have been harder if it was in scientific notation, and that you'd first have to do that. So if I were going to write that non-scientific notation, that's 0.0003 to the fourth power is how it would be written. Okay? So we have, this is a really tiny number to the fourth power, basically. And it's easier to do this computation because the calculator doesn't help us out much here. Yeah, this is correct. Is to first rewrite the 0.00003 as 3 times 10 to the negative 5. It's easier to put in scientific notation to be able to get your final answer in scientific notation. You could try this on a calculator and see what comes up. It will show in scientific notation if you understand how to read your calculator in scientific notation. All right, so the next video will show you how to deal with dividing some numbers by using scientific notation. All we did here was multiply and raise things to powers. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.